I'm a lawyer by profession. I have been involved in complex workplace disputes for over 20 years, either resolving them or litigating them. And the kinds of cases that I've been involved in are public interest cases. So these are women who've returned from maternity leave and just can't get their foot back into the workplace. People who have raised issues in the workplace, such as a consultant surgeon who exposed the threat of harm to patients due to certain policies a hospital was putting in place, and then found himself on the receiving end of being excluded and finally dismissed and losing his career. Or people, senior managers, exposing financial fraud, false accounting, unlawful contracts, and finding themselves on the receiving end of really stringent performance management, excluded from the workplace or severe disciplinary sanctions, and really needing a helping hand at a vulnerable time. And often these cases are against very large companies, well-resourced. But behind each case is often a systemic issue. So the woman who has been sexually harassed, there is often a history of sexual harassment, and there is a wider societal issue of sexual harassment in workplaces, as we know. And so through my work, I have always felt the need to educate, not only to market my cases and bring them out into the public domain, but also rights are illusory. They're useless unless people know about them and unless people have access to them. And so my entire practice has always involved marketing and education and working very closely with journalists, broadcast media, in trying to convey really important stories. Through lockdown, I've been walking a lot, and the people I've been walking with have been some of the thought leaders in this group. And when I say I've been walking with them, they've become quite good friends of mine because I've been listening to their podcasts and I've been listening to talks about the books they've written, people like Rory Sutherland, Paul Skinner. And I came across Marketing Kind, and I saw some of the people that I had been listening to and really thinking about what they had to say. And I saw that they'd be involved in informing and being part of this organization. And I just love the creativity, the vision, and the opportunity to be part of a group that could come together and really make a difference and have a deeper impact with a lot of causes and benefit from that exchange between us as well. So that's why I got involved in Marketing Kind. I've been involved and am still involved in a number of charities based predominantly around my areas of interest. So inequality law, that's sexual harassment and race issues, racial justice, and whistleblowing. And one of the charities, of which I'm a trustee, the Anti-Racist Alliance, is presently developing its website and its marketing communications. And so I need to give some deeper thought about how we're going to really raise the profile of this very important organisation at this time. And I think it'd be really something to get the meeting of the minds and our respected thought leaders around a table to help the ARA. But of course, I do want all our community, all our members and the public to join me and Paul Skinner when we host the next exchange, which is on Wednesday, the 16th of June at 5 p.m. And we have an esteemed panel of speakers. And the title is, How Can We Prepare for the Worst While Aiming for the Best? And we have Professor Rebecca Henderson, we have Sir Oliver Letwin and Rita Chadha, spanning business, government and civil society, really looking deeply at some of the issues that we are facing in society, climate change, post-pandemic issues, racism, and trying to see what the best ways are to solve them. And of course, a big issue that we've all been grappling with through lockdown, the use of technology and where that may lead us in terms of how plugged in we are in our entire lives across everything we do now and the necessity for technology. But what might happen if that technology fails us?